Well, hello everybody! Welcome back to another wonderful day of Sharlenwar's adventure in Factorio. This is our New World series, and off we go to begin. So where do we leave off? Well, we have this stone that we have, because I think we brought it from up here. Let me just double check that. Up here there was a miner driller. Our way is up here. Let's run up here past all these solar panels here. Right here is some stone. That's what I need to take down there. So how is everybody doing? Well, hopefully you're all doing great. And make sure to pause the video here to grab your drink and your tasty treats. And yeah, and get to watching. So what are we going to do today? I'm not too sure what we're going to do today. I know we have to deal with our base. We gotta put in some more power modules and stuff like that, or the modules, but you know, like the solar power array here. Looks like we're backing up on batteries, which is nice, so we'll actually grab a stack of those, and then we'll grab a bunch of these guys here. Let's grab 100 of these. That should be enough. We got some alien packets to drop off. How about belts? What do we need for belts? Let's grab some red belts here. Let's grab 100. Let's see here. The research is all backed up nicely. Red is still going. Blue, purple, that's all backed up nicely. Let's place this guy here. Okay, we got some more stone to drop off. How's all this going? This is starting to back up as well now, so that's perfect. Oh, this stuff isn't complete because we need to put in the copper wiring. How are we going to do the copper wiring, right? Well, actually, we could do something strange here. So for example, if we do that, something like that. I think that will do it. Yeah, so what we can do is we can see this is gonna go this way, I think. Yeah, put it like that. Okay, perfect. Now, so I know what I can do with one of these here is I can have one of these make copper wire and bring it up and around this way. Or I can make it right from this one as well, maybe. Let's see if we can do something like this. So we basically bring this belt like this, bring it up, probably like that, something like that. And then we could put this guy like this, and like this. Alright, and then we can do something like this. Let's see how this goes. And what this will do, maybe what we can do as well is we can put in that and that to make it double belted. Now we need power, so let's put power to all of this. Where's the best place? There and there, doesn't matter. Now that should be operating as well, with circuits on both sides now. So now we've basically doubled the production of circuits nice and neatly, and this might be able to keep up, it might not, but it'll help. It'll help when things are going full bore. I'm just thinking if I could take from here as well. I guess what we could do is essentially you could put a belt like this. That's in the way, but that's okay. We would basically put a belt like this. We would do something like this. Like that. Okay. Then we would simply just put another one out like so. And then just carry on with the belt. Like so. Okay, and this one, like, actually, This one should be like this. Okay, and then we just need belt. There we go. So this should actually help a lot with the production, I hope. So we got that all settled. Perfect. What else do we need to do here? We got lots of wood that we can get rid of, so let's run over. I know we're going to build something here, and I just can't remember what it was. I'd have to watch my last episode, and I'm not going to do that. So let's see here. Throw that there. We need to throw our stone into the processing area there. Right over here. Right here, this one. All this stone go away in there. We got a bunch of iron here. Can we throw this in here? Yes, we can. Perfect. That works. Okay. Looks like we got something that we can reverse. So I'm now using update 12.8. So we'll see if this still works. And it still does. Beautiful. Now I'm not sure what I'm going to do with all this wood. Might do something with it, but I don't know. Let's see here. Map. What are we doing? So we got radar units all the way around. Now what do I want to do? Our actually red thing is actually not as big anymore, so we can actually go after these bases maybe over here. I don't know. So let's check out our research here. I want to do some bullet damage, so let's increase our bullet damage here. That means everything is going to start you kicking into full gear here. Alright, once the research starts to move. This is going to be exciting. So everything's going to kick it to full bore, and we're going to watch the materials start to be used up really quickly. As well as this stuff with the red circuits here, with the plastic. How's our petroleum? How's our light oil? Heavy sulfuric acid. Okay, looks like it's still going. Still waiting for the fuel, basically. We need more fuel to tap into. Where is that going to be? Let's see here. Unless that's a couple right there, purple things, maybe. Where are those guys coming from? I don't know where they're coming from. Okay, so I was going to build stuff over here. Oh yeah, your robot stuff. I think that's what we were going to do, because robots use a few things together. So for example, if we want to build more, I think the robot parts we can build by hand maybe, but we need the flying things. So we need flying robot frames, and then each of the different circuits. And for flying robot frames, we need electric engine unit, battery, and steel plate. Electric engine unit right here. Okay, so electric engine unit. Your batteries here. I'm just trying to think if I should just bring them down. Electric engine unit, battery and steel plate, electronic circuit. Steel plate, electronic circuit. So I just need the batteries. So the batteries we could grab from here. We already got kind of a mess of belts here. We got the batteries going up this way. Be kind of silly to tie into them and to bring them down further. How do we, why don't we tie off of, take them right from the line and put them through here. So let's see, we put this there and then we'll bring, we want to bring it through this way, I think. So that underneath and then underneath. Okay, Okay, that's perfect. Okay, so now what do we do? Okay. Where do you put this guy? Steel plate. So fine robot frame. It's battery, so steel plate. Green circuit. So let's go steel plate. Green circuit. Batteries and electric engine units, right? So we got batteries. I think can do that. Like so, batteries and electric engine units. Maybe like that. We'll dump this off onto a belt, which then will bring the belt this way, which will make the frames. Let's put a power pole. Let's see here. See if that works. Yeah, okay, perfect. Okay, so these are being made. Where are we going to deposit those guys? Well, we need them for both robots, right? For logistic and construction. Okay, so logistics needs. Okay, we just need the circuits. Logistic and construction. So let's actually put this into a box. Okay, then we can place this guy like that. Put that one there. We can probably cap it just at the one stack. We don't need very many frames because of the resources it uses. Okay, so we got that going nicely. So now we just need to make each of these. So we need advanced circuits, flying frames, electronic circuits, flying frames. I might just pull down one of each. Might be the easiest way. So how are we gonna pull down? Let's see here. Probably like this. It's a shame I can't tap into this one. Well, maybe I can. Let's see here. Yeah, we can maybe because I'll be able to pull it underneath here like so, and we'd be able to. Maybe we'll be able to tie in directly. See here. Tie in directly. I think we can do that. Okay, so let's see what we can do with this. I'm thinking that I want to use the frames, but then I'm thinking we don't need to. We still need to bring them down because I want to see. No. Okay, I got distracted. Someone came to the door and got me just completely distracted here. So let's put this there, which will bring the circuits over here. Okay, then actually we could do something like this because we'll be taking from the green circuits, right? And then here we can actually have a belt system with the flying frames. And then here we can build construction robots. Okay, then we can dump those into a container, like so. And there we go, voila. We probably only need a stack at a time to build, and now the bullet damage is finished. How'd that affect research here? And the battery production. How are circuits holding up? Yeah, how's iron holding up? Okay, it looks like the circuits are actually doing quite well. Because both sides can actually go on the one side, so we can keep it all fully loaded, which is nice. And how's this going? The steel. Thinking everything's going okay. How's this production going? Okay, looks like this production's going quite well. Yeah, look at that. That's pretty cool. Pretty amazing stuff. Let's take a look at our miners here, see how they're all doing. These fields are doing good. These power fields. Let's take a look here. This is probably going as fast as it can with the crude that we have, which we don't have much crude. Yeah, everything's going nicely. Good. Good, good, good. How many bullets do we have? We actually don't have very many bullets, so let's grab a bunch of these. Let's check out that solar field up top there. So these batteries. Yeah, these batteries will back up eventually. I think as long as you 50-50 go, then eventually we'll have it all filled up. Ooh, what's this? Oh, that's a turret. Okay, so we need power to these things here. Like so. There you go. And that will have those guys going. Now we just need to create these guys. So they take 45 red circuits each time, huh? I don't need that anymore. Let's see. 45 iron gear, steel plates. Iron gears. Right here. Steel plates. Roboports. I think they take red. Red, yeah, okay. We would have to bring that down, unfortunately. Ah, here we go. Steel. Red and steel, right? So red steel and gear. Gears, iron gears. I see these guys here. So red steel and iron gears. Can I actually put one in the middle here? So we do that, turn this into Roboport thing, and then we grab one of these guys, and then I think the gears, we can try doing that. There, and then we could do this. Now this will be making Roboports. How many do we need? Do we need a box? Let's just see what happens when it starts to build them. Right now it's taking red circuits. Let's actually double it up, maybe they'll make it faster. Now it's doing the steel. And the gear wheels are slowly being used. Let's just use the quick one. This might not be too good of an idea, but these shouldn't be being crafted, maybe. I don't know, it's hard to say. Maybe we need a faster thing there now. Yeah, there we go. So there's more production. There we go. And so then one should eventually get you created at 45, it looks like. And yeah, cool. So there we go. This is where we can build these guys. Now we just need the other kind of robots, which were the logistic robots. So let's do this. Let's extend this out again. Let's put this guy here. We can do this like this. We can go logistic. Where are you? Logistic. Now we just need the red circuits. So we'll just pull that down. So I guess we will need that after all. And let's pull it down like so. Sucks that this is right here, but we'll have to just do this and bring it right in like so. And that should do the trick. And then we need a box for these guys. Like so. And then we'll just need another one of these. Let's put this one here. Let's pick this up. Let's move that light. Do we want to put that light? Let's put it right here. Let's put one right here. Perfect. Okay, cool. So now we got this restricted. We got these. So we just need more flying frames, which I think just take a while. Just like the engines, they take a while. So yeah, everything is hunky-dory here. Except for this stuff. Yeah, no, we only need the one stack. This is just a slow assembly machine. So we'll have to upgrade to assembly 3 maybe. Which we'll do that. We'll upgrade to automation 3. Batteries we can't increase because we need more petroleum. Okay, so we're not going to get that anytime soon, right? Let's see here. Let's take a look at the solar field, and then we'll call it. So today we kind of worked on making some robots, and the solar field here, which is the power system that we have going. Let's see here. So it's still using the steam engines for part of the power. And accumulators for the rest. I don't understand how I can just completely stop using this. But that is okay. I wonder what happens if I place these. Will it screw up? No, it won't. Okay, good. Put these down here. Let's put these here. So that way we have more power generation, which is very important. Let's see here. Perfect. Okay, and we do this side. We put these guys up. Oh, come on. And then the rest are these guys. Must be daytime now, since they're all charging. So it looks like we can almost last the night. Looks like. Got that fish. How about this one now? Can we get this one? Yeah, that one. Those fish are useful. Okay. So I want to push this field down one more, I think. Two, three, four. Yeah, I think this will definitely do it. And one more substation here. Perfect. Yeah, I think this is going to be perfect. And this will complete this grid up here. Okay, let's place this stuff down here. Perfect. Okay, now I can place some more of the batteries, the accumulators. Perfect. Okay, And then we grab these guys. Accumulators. Where are you? There you are. Put these guys here like so. Okay, perfect. And here. Then we need to put these guys up. Okay, and then we do this. Oh, and here we go. Here's another one completed. Perfect. No, that's not in the way. Good. And here we go. And this one's done, as you can tell. Ooh, we're down to this last block of 7,400. That's crazy. Crazy. So this will slowly be used up still. Let's see here. Let's carry on the bus. Put these over. Just in case we ever need them down the road here. Looks like we need more belts. Looks like aliens are attacking again. Just grab a stack of these. Oh yes, okay, so. Right now these are being built because I want priority on the construction versus the logistic. I think that's logistic. Yeah, I want the construction over the logistic because the construction will be useful. Looks like the batteries are building up still because we're still using batteries up. Okay. No worries. Just want to make sure that we know what's going on with our batteries. Let's see here. Okay, perfect. So let's check out the RoboPorts here. So two at a time. I think that's all we'll need. We won't need a box for it. Probably not. So how does this work exactly? Well, there's two zones to the robots. There's the green zone and the orange zone. The orange zone, I think, is the logistics. The green zone is the construction range. So that means these we want to put in the center of the bus. Like around here somewhere. This will make it the center, and then we'll hook in each one on each side of these. So maybe we'll make the first one right here part of this part of the base. We'll make sure all the major stuff is in the construction. I'm just trying to think here how I want to encompass the system. Or we can encompass the system based on our positioning of the wall. And which wall would be the starting wall? Probably this one here. So the orange, the logistics should be just inside. Let's see here. So somewhere like right here maybe? Like that. So that way then the construction can extend out a range, or to save, we can place it there. So that way they would repair the base. Let's take a look here. It's powered. So watch. Now if we grab this one, put it like here somewhere. The furnaces are in the way. But if you put it here, we can connect it in and then have our entire base covered. Well, almost. See, up here we need this to go up to here. Decisions, hey? Decisions. Looks like this one's gone. Let's grab that. Yeah, the copper, we're slowly chewing that up, so we're gonna have to tap it into some new copper. We got lots of copper all around us, and not a big deal. Copper and iron. Probably tap into this resource here and then just kind of pipe it in. I could expand this solar field here a little bit, maybe. But yeah, but I think that's about it for this episode. So thank you everybody for watching. Hopefully you've enjoyed this episode, and I look forward to seeing you in the next one. Bye bye.